What's up, guys? Eric Fasquist here with a brand new design basics video for you today from designcuts.com. And in this lesson, we're going to be talking about creating text effects using the layer styles panel in Adobe Photoshop. Now, we're going to break this into a few different parts, but today I want to show you one of my favorite methods and tricks for creating better glows and type of neon effects for your type in Adobe Photoshop. So let's get right into it. Now, over here in Photoshop, I just have a new document set up. The size doesn't really matter all that much. This is just a 4x6 kind of document here. And all I want to do is go ahead and maybe choose some type of rounded typeface. And for this, you can just use whatever you happen to have. You know, it doesn't have to be anything super fancy, but having a rounded edge will definitely help give that kind of illusion of a neon type of sign. Okay, so let's just go ahead and type out a title, or let's say that this is for something like, you know, a season 2 kind of promo for a TV show or something like that, right? Why not? All we're going to do here is just place our text nice and big in the middle, and then let's go ahead and double click on the text layer to bring up our layer styles. Now, a lot of time the layer styles get kind of a bad rap because people just kind of use them, very basic settings. They might not even really change that much. Okay, but what we're going to do is look at a few of the ways that you can combine some of these things to create more interesting looking effects. So here what I'm doing is applying an outer glow, and let's just go ahead and make it red. Okay, and then we're going to leave the blend mode set to screen, the spread set to 0, and the size, depending on the size of your text, somewhere around 20 to 40 pixels is pretty good. But we're not going to stop there. What we want to do next is add a drop shadow. Now over here, we'll change the blend mode from multiply to normal. Let's go ahead and change the color from blue to something like yellow or orange. Okay, and then we can begin to play around with some of these settings a little bit. Now as I increase the size, you guys can see over here on the left what's happening. And if I just check and uncheck that box, you can already see the effect that it's having. It's creating a much more interesting looking effect. And by playing around with some of these blending modes, you can get even more interesting looking results. All right, so I think in this case, linear dodge looks pretty good. And then you can also go ahead and add on additional instances of this effect, which is a really nice kind of feature here in the newer versions of Photoshop. So just by clicking this small effects icon on the bottom, we can go ahead and add another drop shadow. Okay, come down to that one. That one's in the middle here. And then let's go ahead and play around with the settings for that. Now I'll jack up the opacity a little bit, okay, and then change it from multiply to normal, okay, and then we don't really need to do much with the spread. You know, let's make the size a little bit smaller, and then you can go in and kind of just see what happens when you change the colors a little bit. So let's see, if I make that red, and then maybe change it to overlay, okay, reduce the opacity a little bit, reduce the size, and just experiment with some of these settings a little bit, you can see that you can start to get some pretty cool looking outer glows. All right, but what about the inner part of the text? Let's look at some of the ways that we can customize that. Now the layer styles in Photoshop are extremely powerful. You can see just by creating more instances and adding on and building on to some of the default effects that we have available to us here, that you can begin to combine and create even more interesting looking effects. And throughout this series, I'll show you guys a few different ways that you can do that. And it's sort of the same idea that you would have in mind when you're working with filters. Of course, using a canned effect like that right out of the box might not always be great looking, but that's why it gets a bad rap. And that's why you have to go in, experiment, and play around and try a few different things out. So now let's go ahead and add a gradient overlay. And for this, I'm just going to go ahead and change a few of the colors here. Maybe we'll go with like a dark grayish blue color. And then we'll make the top color here maybe like a yellow, all right, something kind of bright like that. Let me change this actually, keep it in the same family at least. All right, something like this is looking okay. All right, but then let's add a color overlay on top of that. Now for this, I'll go with maybe an orange and try changing the blending mode here to overlay or soft light perhaps, and then play around with the opacity a little bit. Okay, and you can see the effect that that's having on the gradient overlay. It's making it a little bit brighter. So then you can also come back into the gradient overlay and maybe manipulate some of those colors as well. You can add a more saturated red color. Maybe we can add, you know, a little bit of an orange tint there and play around with the position of these colors inside of this gradient as well. Okay, so maybe instead there we can use something a bit darker. Bring these colors a little bit closer together or spread them out depending on what looks good. You know, there's no right or wrong kind of way to do this. It's just about getting in there and experimenting with a few different things until you find something that looks good. All right, so here I'm saving kind of the brightest areas of color for the very top of the design here, all right, for the top of our text. All right, and then I'm just going to spread these colors out a little bit. Maybe bring that in some. Let's see what happens if we just lose that color there. All right, that's not looking bad so far. And then let's come in here and add a satin effect. Now here I'm going to change the blending mode, maybe to overlay to see what that looks like. All right, and I'm not crazy about it, so I'm just going to skip that and then move on. Now let's add an inner glow here. But before we do that, I'm going to come back to my color overlay, maybe change the blend mode to multiply just to make it a little bit darker. And now for the inner glow, we'll reduce the size. Make sure the blending mode is set to something like screen, which gives us a nice bright edge. Okay, and then we can just experiment with the size here to determine, you know, how thick or thin we want those outer edges to be. Okay, and don't be afraid to experiment a little bit with some of these effects. Okay, maybe we can change the outer glow color here to yellow instead, reduce the size, make our drop shadow more of a red color. Okay, increase the size of that. Let's see how that looks on linear dodge or color dodge. I think linear dodge looks pretty good. All right, and then we can bring back in our third copy there, which really sets it off using that combination of an outer glow set to screen on top of a drop shadow set to red with linear dodge, on top of a drop shadow with orange and linear dodge. All right, so that combination looks pretty good to me. And then you can also add that inner glow like we talked about and just see what some of those different color combinations look like. But I think in this case, going with like a nice bright orange or yellow really looks good. The satin can look pretty nice. It's not absolutely essential, but it definitely adds a bit more contrast to your text. So let's go ahead and click OK. And you can see that we have quite a few of these effects here, but just by combining those things, we've created a really nice looking outer glow effect that looks 10 times better easily than just a standard outer glow effect that you might see a lot of people using in Photoshop. And just like that, you guys have created this cool effect that you can reuse for any of your designs. So as you can see, the layer styles in Photoshop are extremely versatile and extremely powerful. It's all about experimenting with them and finding interesting and unique ways to combine some of these effects. So I hope that you guys have enjoyed this quick tip as part of our Design Basics video series. We'll be doing a few more of these where I show you guys how to create some other similar type of text effects. But if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and give us a thumbs up and smash that like button. Be sure to subscribe to the Design Cuts YouTube channel and leave thoughts and comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Eric Vasquez, and we'll see you next time.